All right, so in this video, I'm going to show you where to strategically place your keywords so it maximizes your on-page SEO. All right, let's check it out. Okay, so in our last video, I showed you how to set up your title and your web address so it can be seen on Google. The next thing you want to do is you want to strategically place your keywords throughout your blog post so that it can be easily identified by Google that this is indeed the right article for this particular keyword. So I'm going to show you how to set it up inside WordPress. Okay, so here we are back inside of our WordPress blog post that we've been working on. And you can see right here, my keyword is podcasting A to Z review. The very first thing that I do is I want to make sure that this keyword is in the first, maybe 100 words, first paragraph of your blog post. So you can see right here, it's placed right here, and it's also placed right here. Now, in order to even more identify it for Google and say, point all the arrows in this direction, this article is about podcasting A to Z, I basically italicized it, I bolded it, and I put it in quotation marks. And I basically putting a big red arrow saying to Google, this is about podcasting A to Z. And throughout the webs, the blog post, I also strategically place it throughout. So right here, it's also underlined right here. It's placed for podcasting A to Z right here. The key thing is you want to make sure that your blog post still reads very naturally, that it doesn't look spammy, that you're just placing a whole bunch of keywords in there and it just doesn't read naturally. You still want to make sure that the content reads naturally and that people still like to read your content. So, you know, people used to say your keyword, you know, percentage of how many times you should put it in your blog post should be like 5% or something. Google has recently made some updates to the algorithm to saying that they will penalize you if you spam your blog post with too many of your keywords. So you want to make sure you just kind of put in there, I would say, maybe about 1% of what your blog post is. So because my word count is about 2,665 for this blog post, you know, I put it in there maybe a couple times, but, you know, as long as you have it in the very beginning, somewhere in the middle, and you want to make sure it's somewhere towards the end. So I have it in the very last paragraph of my blog post right here, podcasting A to Z. And it, once again, it's also underlined. So make sure that you have it structured inside your blog post. Like I said, in the very beginning, one of the first 100 words, somewhere in your middle paragraph, maybe two or three times, and at the end of your last paragraph as well. All right, so in the next video, I'm going to show you how to set H headings, so that way Google also can identify that this is indeed the correct keyword for people's searches. I'll see you guys in the next video.